Dear students, I welcome you all to the class of English Compulsory, BA second year. We have been dealing with the short story from unit number 1, that is fiction. The title of the story is The Lost Child, written by Mulk Raj Anand. Mulk Raj Anand is one of the notable Indian writers who earned name and fame to Indian writing in English through his outstanding contribution to the development of Indian writing in English. He penned a number of short stories. He wrote number of novels. His notable novels are Untouchable, Coolie, and Two Leaves and a Bud. He was awarded International Peace Prize in 1953 and Padma Bhushan and Sahitya Academy Award for his outstanding contribution to Indian writing in English. The present story, The Lost Child, comprises certain themes such as universality of a child's nature, curious nature of a child, aspiration, demands and realization of a child, a strong bond of love between a child and parents, and true value of parents in the life of child. The Lost Child is a story of a small child who goes to the fair accompanied by his parents, and he comes across a number of curious things. On his way to the fair, there in the fair, and finally the child gets lost from his parents, and a generous and gentleman comes to him and he tries to soothe the crying heart of the child. The man tries to give him comfort by offering toys, balloons, sweet. But the child does not want those beautiful or attractive things offered by that gentleman. Finally, the child says, "I want my parents." So, friends, we understand the affinity between a small child and his parents. At the same time, we understand importance or value of parents in the life of a child. This is very interesting story. The setting of the story is of spring season, and when winter season is over, in summer season, the spring season lies in India. When it is winter season, people are confined in their habitations. It is not possible for them to come out and enjoy the sunny sunlight. As everywhere there is chilly coldness all around, which is beyond tolerance. So people get confined themselves in their habitations during winter season. When winter season is over, people come out of their habitations and they enjoy life, especially in summer season. And we know in India, we have number of fairs. We have number of annual festivals, especially in summer season. So Mulk Raj Anand has set this story, The Lost Child, in the spring season. The winter season has passed. All the people came out of their houses and they were cheerful as the chilling cold weather had ended. A little child with his parents goes to a fair. He is happy and excited. So winter season is over and people are very happy, they have come out of their habitations, and there is a small child or little child, he goes to the fair along with his parents. The child is very much excited, and it is commonly seen that when there is a fair, small children are very happy, they are excited, and there is no bound to their happiness or to there is no bound to their excitement. It is same in the case of this child as well, because it is universal nature of child. The child's first demand. What happens, you know, when the child follows his parents and they are on the way to the fair, there are number of shops set beside the road and different varieties of beautiful toys or attractive toys were placed in those shops, and all the toys were very attractive, so child could not help himself from attracting towards those beautiful toys. So the child started demanding those toys at his father, and father reacted with the child in a very furious manner. He looked at the child with red eyes. Father did not want to buy those toys for the child. So however, mother interfered and she offered her finger to the child to hold and walk forward. Mother tries to divert the attention of the child, saying that see, look ahead, look ahead. There is a beautiful spectacle, and in front of, in the open space, there were mustard flower or mustard field. There was mustard field. It was flowered everywhere. There were flowers, yellow, beautiful flowers were there, and number of insects were zooming over those beautiful flowers, such as honeybees, butterflies were flapping, honeybees were flying hither and thither, collecting nectar from the bloomed flowers, and dragonflies were zooming over that edge of yellow space, let us say. The child followed them to catch, but was unable to catch them. Child was so excited seeing that beautiful spectacle, and child started running after the butterflies. The child started running after the honeybees, and child started running after the dragonflies. Child wanted to catch them, but was unable to do so. His mother called him as they started walking. The child joined his parents once again, but this time he stopped to see insect coming out of the soil. He was left behind and again called by his parents. The child joined his parents in the grove, and as they were going through the trees were bloomed with different varieties of flowers, and as they were moving through the forest, or they were moving through the grove, so there was shower of flowers. So petals were falling down on the ground, and this is how grove or trees were showering their petals over the heads of these parents and their child. Child forgot about everything and began to collect once again fallen petals of the flowers. As the child was busy collecting the fallen petals, just then he heard the cooing of the doves. He started chasing the birds and dropped the petals. Suddenly, his attention was diverted towards the birds. He forgot about collecting those fallen petals of the flowers. And again, the child started chasing the birds. Child wanted to catch those birds, but it was not possible for him to catch flying doves. Parents again called the child. They started marching towards the fair through the mustard field. As they neared the village, the child experienced a huge crowd from all the directions, and the child was initially confused but felt attracted later on. So, in the last class yesterday, we these things, or we were at this at that point that parent reached to the particular point from where they could see the fair, and the place or the fair was nothing but huge crowd of people. Child was so excited to see that, and the small village, it was village, and that village was crowded with the people from all directions. So initially the child was little bit confused to see, but later on he was attracted towards the fair. Let us proceed ahead with the discussion of rest of the story with the help of the textbook now. A sweetmeat seller hawked. So far child has come across different spectacles. At the outset, on the way, child saw attractive toys. Then the child came across fallen petals of the flowers. Child came across beautiful mustard flowers. Then the child came across flying butterflies, then flapping butterflies, zooming dragonflies, then the honeybees, and the child tried to catch the doves, and the child forgot about everything. And finally, the child has come to the fair, and now another spectacle is there. So what we notice right from beginning of the story is the child's attention is continuously diverted from this thing to that thing, from that thing to other thing, another thing. So here we understand curiosity of the child. So definitely the nature of child is very curious, and Mulk Raj Anand has skillfully presented the curiosity of child in the present story, The Last Child. A sweetmeat seller hawked. Gulab Jamun, Rasgulla, Barfi, Jalebi, at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd pressed around his counter at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweets decorated with leaves of silver and gold. So there was a sweet vendor, and he was selling his sweet, shouting Gulab Jamun, Rasgulla, Barfi, Jalebi, and his sweet stall was surrounded, or it was covered by the people. So there were different varieties of sweet items were kept in his stall. The child started, the child stared open-eyed, and his mouth watered for the Barfi. That was his favorite sweet. As the child heard the sound of the sweet vendor who was shouting, Gulab Jamun, Rasgulla, Barfi, Jalebi, that time child was attracted towards that sweet shop because there was his favorite sweet, that is Barfi. Child was fond of Barfi, so he was attracted towards that Barfi stall, sweet stall. So the child wanted to buy that Barfi. So he demanded once again at his father, I want that Barfi. He slowly murmured. Child did not shout. Slowly, in a low voice, child demanded his father to buy Barfi for him. But he half knew as he begged that his playa would not be heeded because his parent would say he was greedy. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So initially, child was quite familiar with the nature of his father, or his parents, let us say. As the child demanded that a beautiful toy at his father, father looked at him with red eye. So this time child did not ask his father to buy Barfi with a high pitch, but just murmured. And later on the child realized that his parents would not pay any attention towards his demand, so just he moved forward and he followed. There was a flower seller hawked. A garland of gulmohar. So there was a flower seller, and he had different varieties of garlands in his basket, and he was selling them. So a garland of gulmohar, he started shouting in order to attract the attention of the customers. The child seemed irresistibly drawn. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured, I want that garland. But he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers because they would say that they were cheap. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So on the way, the child has been attracted by two things here. The first thing, the sweet vendor who was trying to attract the attention of the customers, calling the name of his sweets such as Gulab Jamun, Rasgulla, Barfi, Jalebi. Child was attracted because there was one of his favorite sweet, that is Barfi. Child just murmured, child wanted to buy Barfi, but could not make a demand loudly before his parents because he knew the nature of his parents, so he did not demand it any further, let us say. So just moved on. Later on, there was a flower seller and he was selling flower. So he was also trying to attract the attention of the customers, shouting a garland of Gulmohar, a garland of Gulmohar. This time also child wanted to buy one of the garlands, but later on realized that it was not possible for him to get that garland because his parents may not purchase or his parents may not buy that garland for him. So the child just followed his parents. So friends, in the following class, that is on tomorrow, we shall continue rest of the story. With this, I would like to remain here. Thank you very much.